So, Bob, have you ever been camping before?
Yes, of course I've been camping before.
I'm so thrilled to be talking with you, David Cross and Deborah Messing. We're going to be talking about The Dark Divide. This is based on a true story and really a very different type of role that we're seeing. Tell me a little bit about that.
Yeah, that's what really, you know, brought me to it was the, I'm not often afforded these opportunities, and I love the story. Robert Pyle, the guy whose story we're telling, is such the most wonderful, optimistic, avuncular human being you've ever met. And it's his wife that really pulled that out of him. And when he really depended on and leaned on her quite a bit.
Can't wait to read the first draft of his next book.
We've been talking about this for years now.
Let's dial back on you being so miserable.
I apologize, but my wife is
alive. I'm alive.
Dave Koechner is joining us now as well. Deborah, I have to talk to you about the physicality of your role. Tell me a little bit about her and her story and her relationship with her husband.
You know, the reason I was drawn to this film was because I've never been asked to do a role as challenging as this before. And I love the fact that it was a true story. My whole thing was just trying to understand what it's like to have cancer, what that does to a marriage, and what happens as you approach death.
So, you're married?
I fell in love with her the second I heard her name, Tia Linnea.
Linnea, like the little twin flowers.
Yeah, of course.
And David, so was your physicality as well. Have you ever done anything like that before? I mean, you spent most of the film in your underwear. Which was very entertaining. But there was a lot of physicality for you. What was that like?
I mean, I love doing that physical stuff. A lot of those scrapes and bruises, I had. A lot of that stuff is just real.
How long you been on the trail?
I don't know. I guess I've lost track.
Seems ill-advised to be hiking so long without a radio or rifle. What if you run into a bear?
And I want to get to some of those kind of real characters that you stumbled upon in the woods as well. Dave plays one of those characters.
It's not the first time that I've played a guy who's an ass.
She thought you were a Bigfoot.
Do I look like a goddamn Bigfoot to you?
It's an opportunity to, A, find that even the most despicable people have humanity. And what my job is to hopefully let the audience know that these people are humans. They're not just these cardboard cutouts.
What are you hoping that people walk away with when they see this film?
I hope that they are given a beautiful respite from the world that we're living in right now. I mean, right now, Oregon and Washington are burning. So to be able to enter, to go visit Oregon and Washington and see just how magnificent it is, and to see that it's our responsibility to protect the treasures that is nature. I mean, for me, I hope that it gives people some comfort.
I don't know what happens next, but I'll be ready.